What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos Silencer, and welcome back. And today you're going to watch some Team Defender gameplay for Mentally Dazed. He was nice enough to shoot this to me. I couldn't get my own this morning, so he would let me use his. So his link is in the description. You guys make sure you check out his channel. Let him know that Chaos sent you over there. And today I want to talk about, and you guys have probably heard of many ways to rank up, get a lot of XP, and do it quickly. And I wanted to talk about one because I get a lot of people that ask me questions on how to rank up and what's the fastest way to rank up. And we're at that point with Modern Warfare 3 where we're at a crossroads, and this is where people kind of split. You get to the point where you get in that danger zone of it getting boring. So some people go with, I'm not going to prestige anymore. I'm going to max out and get all my gold guns and unlock all kinds of stuff and do different classes and have fun with that. And that's where I'm at right now. I'm having fun using different guns and upgrading them, getting some gold camos, doing different setups and stuff like that. On the other end of it, people decide, well, for me to keep my attention span going for Modern Warfare 3, I need to just roll through and get as high prestige as I can. That's my goal, is to prestige as quick as I can and roll through the next one and get these prestige emblems and get up to the highest ranked prestige possible. So I'm going to help you guys with that. If that's the road you are taking, the road probably more traveled, I would say, at this point. And the game type is Team Defender, and a lot of you have already heard of this, but some of you haven't. Like I said, you were asking for it, so I'm going to give you guys some tips on it. Team Defender is basically where one team gets, that you capture the flag, and you hold the flag as long as you can, and the team with the most points at the end wins. Now, when you have the flag, you get bonuses and you get more XP or points, and so does the guy with the flag. So your entire team benefits if you have somebody that's holding the flag. Now, if you're on the team with the guy that has the flag, you're going to get 100 points per kill, or 100 XP, whatever you want to call it. If you're the actual flag carrier, you're going to get 250 points per kill or XP. Now, if you're on the team without the flag, you're going to get the normal 50 points per kill. So obviously what you want to do here is maximize the time that your team has the flag and maximize the time that you individually have the flag if possible, if that scenario comes up. So here's a couple ways to do that. First, play with a group of six. Play in a party. Everybody have mics on, because you're going to want to communicate in Team Defender, because the spawn systems are horrendous, very, very bad. And if you're doing this the right way and you're doing it to level up fast and win, you definitely want to be able to communicate in a full party. On top of that, you want to, and this is just my suggestion, have everybody run the trophy system, because Team Defender can be a bit campish. It doesn't really benefit a group to run around as much. If you have the flag, the idea is like you're playing, you guys are the fortress, and it might as well be called Team Fortress. You're the fortress and they're trying to penetrate it and get the flag. So treat it as such. Have everybody run trophy systems and set those up. That's going to keep the grenades out. That's going to keep the predator missiles out. And if you have six of those set up, you're good to go. I mean, there's not much going to get through there in the matter of explosives. Also, have everybody run blast shield. If you guys are playing it as a team thing and you're picking a spot on a map, there's numerous different spots on maps you can hold up in buildings or in the corners of the map. You want to be able to, in your peripheral, be able to see any enemies coming and not, you want to be in a corner to a degree, because you don't want people to be able to spawn behind you. And like I said, the spawn systems are very, very bad. So if you'll do those things, you can pretty much ensure that your winning percentage is going to be up there, and you can pretty much ensure that your team plus you is going to rank up very, very fast. Now, with double XP being over for the Mountain Dew and the Doritos thing, people are looking for other ways to do it. It's not really, how would you say, prestige token friendly to go spend a prestige token on 2 hours of XP. 2 hours of XP doesn't last that long. Now, weapon XP, if you're close to getting a gold gun and you want to do it, that's a different story, but you don't really want to waste those tokens on something like 2 hours of double XP. So this is a very good alternative. Make sure you have a six-man team. Everybody has mics. Run those trophy systems. Set them up. Pretend like you're playing a Team Fortress where you're protecting the castle and those guys can't get in, and your guy with the flag is the king. If you want to look at it as a chess game, you could do it that way. Make sure everybody's running blast shield, so in case any of those grenades or predator missiles or anything like that get through, maybe you have a chance of withstanding it. And always pick a corner of the map or a place where you can see the enemy in your peripheral, because, like I said, the spawn systems are really, really, really bad. And if you're lucky enough to be the guy to get that flag and you're on one of these super teams and you hold that flag the whole match and you get you some kills, you're gonna go up even quicker because you're getting 250 points per kill. So that's it, guys. I hope that answered the question. I hope that helps you guys level up if you took the path of it's time to start prestiging my ass off in Modern Warfare 3 as opposed to me, who took the path of I'm never prestiging again. I'm going to unlock all my weapons and gold camo and use all kinds of funky classes. That's it, guys. Make sure you check out Mentally Dazed. His link is in the description. He's the one that provided this gameplay. As always, rate and comment on the video. And if this helped you in any way and you really enjoyed it, don't be afraid to add it to your favorites on your playlist. Jimmy, your Chaos Silencer. Peace.
And please be sure to follow Chaos on Twitter. You know you want to.